1, 2, 1, 2. Yeah. Special dedication to my brothers and sisters on the great continent of Africa. The saints in Malawi, Ghana, Nigeria, Kenya, Zimbabwe. Don't be deceived by what America's sending y'all, yeah, man.
Let me begin. While there's still ink left in my pen, I'm set to contend. For truth, you can bet will offend. Deception within the church, man, who's letting them in? We talked about this years ago. Let's address it again. Yeah, and I ain't really trying to start beef, but some who claim to be part of the sheep got some sharp teeth. And cats get mean when you criticize them. But Jesus told us, Matthew 7:16, we can recognize them. And God forbid that for the love of some fans, I keep quiet and watch them die with their blood on my hands. So there's nothing left for me to do except to speak to you in the spirit of Jude 3 and 2 Peter 2. And I know that some will label me a Pharisee, because today the only heresy is saying that this heresy. I'll dare to be specific and drop some clarity on the popularity of the gospel of prosperity. Turn off TBN, that channel is overrated. The pastors speak bogus statements, financially motivated. It's kinda like a pyramid scheme. Visualize heretics Christianizing the American dream. It's foul and deceitful, they're lying to people, teaching that camels squeeze through the eye of a needle. Ungodly and wicked, ask yourself, how can they not be convicted? Treating Jesus like a lottery ticket, and you're thinking they're not the dangerous type, cause some of the statements are right. That only proves that Satan comes as an angel of light. This teaching can't be believed without a cost. The lie is you can achieve a crown without a cross. And I hear it all the time when they speak on the block. Even unbelievers are shocked how they're fleecing the flock. It should be obvious then. Yeah, I'll explain why it's sin. Peep the Bible, it's in 1 Timothy 6:9-10. It talks about how the desire for riches has left many souls on fire in stitches, mired in ditches. Tell me, who would teach you to pursue as a goal the very thing that the Bible says will ruin your soul, huh? Yet they're encouraging the love of money. To make it worse, they've exported this garbage into other countries. My heart breaks even now as I'm rhyming. You wanna know what all false teachers have in common?
What?
It's called selfism, the fastest growing religion. They just dress it up and call it Christian. Don't be deceived by this funny biz. If you come to Jesus for money, then he's not your God.
Money is.
Jesus is not a means to an end.
No.
The gospel is he came to redeem us from sin. And that is the message forever, I'll yell. Now. If you're living your best life now, you're headed for hell.
Talk to him.
Joel Osteen.
False teacher.
Let him know.
Preble Dollar is a false teacher.
Well to well.
Benny Hinn is a false teacher.
I know they're popular, but don't let them deceive ya.
Talk to him.
T.D. Jakes is a false teacher.
Tell the truth.
Joyce Meyer is a false teacher.
Let him know.
Paula White is a false teacher.
Use your discernment, let the Bible lead ya.
Keep going.
Fred Price is a false teacher.
Tell the truth.
Kenneth Copeland is a false teacher.
Well to well.
Robert Tilton is a false teacher.
I know they're popular, but don't let them deceive ya.
Talk to him.
Eddie Long is a false teacher.
Let him know.
Juanita Bynum is a false teacher.
Discernment, let the Bible lead ya.
But false prophets also arose among the people, just as there will be false teachers among you, who will secretly bring in destructive heresies, even denying the master who bought them, bringing upon themselves swift destruction. And many will follow their sensuality, and because of them, the way of truth will be blasphemed. And in their greed, they will exploit you with false words. Their condemnation from long ago is not idle, and their destruction is not asleep. 2 Peter 2:1-3.